Field producer, rap.
Hey there. Hello.
Hello, everybody.
We're talking about Minnesota's own Joe Mauer. Joe Mauer and Adam Thielen are like our
heroes.
Legends.
Kids
can look up to and be like, yeah. I can make it to, you know, this if I work hard enough.
What's a better story of the two? The one guy who was the best ever.
Adam Thielen, hands down.
Yeah, right.
Because Joe Mauer was known that he was a phenom.
Right.
At a young age.
He was good at all sports, right?
Adam Thielen
he was going to Florida State for...
They should make a movie off of Adam Thielen's story.
I think they should.
The fact he was like D3, or what is Mankato?
D2. But it's all the same.
And then he tried out, like when they just do open tryouts. He tried out.
Oh, that's how that happened?
Oh, you don't know that story?
No, I don't know the story.
You got to go watch it.
It's crazy. They did did they do 30 for 30 on him? Or they did some sort of story on him.
Yeah, they did.
So he was going to like a D2 college, like a Division II college.
Locally, Mankato State.
And just decided, hey, I want to continue my football career. I'm going to go to the Vikings and I'm going to see what happens.
Yeah,
and
then he paid like $250 to go. He was working at a dental office and he was the front desk guy at a dental office.
He's got great teeth.
Yeah, he was like making like $12 an hour.
Uh-huh.
And he's like, yeah, I'm gonna go try out for the Vikings. I'm like, okay,
that's on the level of Kurt
it's
Warner.
So cool.
Because Kurt Warner was bagging groceries,
right.
And decided to go and try out for the Rams, and he's Super Bowl champion.
Yeah,
and
it is
Hall of Famer.
It's really cool. And then like he was amazing year one, and then he just kept getting better and better and better. It was just so fun to watch.
Yeah, I mean, that they should make a movie out of him. The fact that he beat out Cordero Patterson, this stud athlete,
mm-hmm.
right?
That's if you just believe and work. Like, that's a good true story of, like, believing in yourself and what you have to give.
This was supposed to be about Joe Mauer.
Yeah, we're talking about Joe Mauer. I didn't know Joe Mauer also was really good at football. Like, he was number one USA Today article back when he was in high school. Did you know that?
Number one athlete
this
in every
much,
sport.
Not much. You guys know way more.
I wonder if he could have picked, you know, like, if colleges were and universities were looking at him and they're like, we want you to play football.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, I like baseball.
Yeah, he just liked baseball more.
Right.
That was just what it was. It was just
there's
love.
More money, depending on your position.
Less
right?
injury, less wear and tear on your body.
Yeah.
Except his knees. We were like, guy needs some new knees, probably. Imagine being the catcher, like, and you're just bending the whole game.
Yeah.
But
those are the years.
Also, thick life-saving thighs, I assume.
Life-saving
if you're, like,
thighs.
Squatting for an entire game,
oh,
your thighs
gosh.
Are just like tree trunks. Just
wait, look. Why don't I, is this a reference that I don't
know? Thick thighs save lives.
Oh.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a thing. We
yes,
all know
they
that.
Do.
I'll look it up.
Just remember that. Okay. Anytime you're in danger, just remember thick thighs. It'll save your life.
Thick thighs. Mm-hmm. Anyway, speaking of Joe Mauer, his thick thighs, his thick burn.
Did he
I didn't know they gave those out.
They did those, yeah.
That's like, so funny.
I went to that game. It was awesome.
I wonder if anybody still has those at home. I would love to see what those look like.
Were they little like pieces of paper that you put
on?
No,
they were little like fuzzy things.
Little,
stuck on.
Little felt.
We got to find in the archives.
It was such an early 2000s, 90, like the long, my older brother, who's probably the same age as Joe Mauer, had the long burns. It was in.
But it was hot. It was hot.
It was hot.
He was hot.
He was. That's why I bought his uniform. I mean, he is still. You're still a good-looking man. Okay, now we're just creeping. We're getting a little too. His wife is like, we're not watching Sunrise.
He's slowly clicking the close window button on his computer.
Just shutting the laptop.
Oh, my gosh. I'm trying to think. Like, I went to 10 straight years of like road trips with my friends, and those were during the Joe Mauer years.
Stalking him.
I'm just kidding. T. Hunt, you know, Torrey Hunter, Joe Mauer.
God, y'all had some good squads back then. It's a shame that they never
06,
won a world championship.
06 is like the hardest year ever. We had Francisco Liriano was a rookie that year. He's like going to be the best pitcher of all time. And we had Johan Santana.
Wow.
And we had the MVP was Morneau that year.
Mm-hmm.
So we had the Cy Young, the up-and-coming Cy Young, the MVP, and we got swept by the A's.
Mm.
Wow.
Crazy. I have a bat signed by Morneau.
Do you?
It sits in our bedroom and it's like my husband's bat if he hears like a noise.
An intruder.
I don't know what to
do. Put that down.
I don't know if we're supposed to hang it up or use it.
I think you should hang it up. It has his signature on it.
Because he's Canadian.
Randy Jackson also signed the bat.
Randy Jackson ruined it.
Do you leave it under
the bed? No, it's from a movie. Come on.
Oh,
I was going to say Randy Jackson.
He signed your samurai sword?
Baseball? Yeah, okay,
okay,
got it.
It's from Step Brothers,
it's Step
but no one got it,
oh
so then
God.
I had to explain it, and then it was not great.
I was like, Randy Jackson, he's an American Idol judge. Why would he sign your back?
Remember from Step Brothers?
Yes, I get it now. Oh, my goodness.
Did anyone in the booth understand that joke? No. No one did? Okay, well.
It's fine. Somebody out there.
The internet.
Joe Mauer did. He's still, he opened back his laptop and he's watching again.
He's like, I really want to watch these Jackson talk too. About my Randy sideburns.
Moving on. Oh, wait. Do you remember when we saw him at the fair?
Randy
was
Jackson?
Was that
with you? No. Oh. She's like, what?
I wish I saw him at
I
the
know.
Fair. Like, hey, dog.
Hey, dog. Yeah, hey,
Randy
dog.
Jackson, if you're watching this morning, call us. We want you on
I
the
love
show.
That Jason thinks everybody's watching it. I love it. Like,
every time. They're watching.
Doesn't Cousins watches us, right? Every day.
Every day. Yep. I don't know. Captain Kirk, I see you. I saw Joe Mauer with his twins at the fair. And I was going to go up. He was already getting bombarded. You know his face.
Yeah.
Everyone knows his face.
I know his face.
I know you do. But we left him alone. That's how Minnesotans do it with celebrities, which is why Prince loved it here.
We just could look
at him from afar, and then you're like, that's cool, I see him, but I'm not going to bug him.
Yeah, nobody's going to run up to Prince.
Isn't that what people do to you every day? Anyway?
I don't have that clout or the... No, people don't know.
Are you sure? People don't come up to you and say, oh, my God.
No, actually, people recognize my voice more than my... face. Mm-hmm. Like yesterday, this principal at a school, I started talking. She's like, Alicia's here. I was like, hello. I think that's kind of fun. Because people are getting ready in the morning. They don't really watch all the time. They listen.
Yeah, they're listening to our voices and not
listen
at our
to
faces.
My voice. Anywho, okay, moving on from
congratulations
Joe Mauer.
To Joe, by the way.
That
sorry,
is so great.
Sorry for objectifying you.
Really fun.
Yes,
it was awesome.
Are, sorry.
I mean, you don't just, it's just awesome. You don't get it a lot.
You're a cool guy. Yeah. Cool guy. So let's talk about this. We do this here on the show all the time. Where we draw out saying goodbye.
Mm-hmm. We do. And everybody in the booth hates it.
They don't like us here.
But Minnesota goodbyes.
It's a real thing.
Yeah.
It's just known. And I wear it like a badge of honor.
Do you?
My husband hates it.
You can't help it. So you might as well.
He literally be like, let's leave at this time. And I'm like, okay. And then he'll be like, the car's going. I'm like, all right. And I'm still doing my rounds, saying bye to right. family members. So it's like the holiday time.
Your husband's the one that's like, come on.
Yeah.
Nicole does
and then
that
he
to
gives
me.
Up. No. We've been together like 17 years. He gives up. He's like, I didn't even start the car this time.
Why is that a thing? I've discovered that it's a thing since I moved here. Like,
I feel guilt
have
if I don't
inability.
Say goodbye to everyone that I said hello to.
Yeah.
So do I.
Because I don't see them often enough. Or
like everybody at the party?
Probably.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I will go to every single person and hug them. So even if I'm at my boys' house and there's 12 of us there, I will hug every single one of them. Tell them I love them.
Mm-hmm. Love
I would
you,
never
man.
Just leave. Be like, did
it's
I say bye
so
to Jesse?
Why not just do a blanket? Hey, everybody, I'm leaving. It was
you
great.
Could.
No.
Because
party
you didn't
dope.
Give hugs
to
everybody.
That's how they do it
everybody.
In Philadelphia, maybe.
They're notorious for that. Just right. say, hey, everybody, I'm leaving. Goodbye.
Right.
I don't know.
I don't know what it is. Also, like, I don't want to leave the party. I don't know. I kind of like... We're supposed to leave, but I don't really want to leave yet.
And then somebody offers you another
right.
drink.
I get a lot of FOMO.
Yeah.
So
I was
my buddy George from New York in Madison.
Yeah.
And he would always just bail.
I was like, whoa.
Where did they go? Then I was like, well, we're all still friends with him the next day, so it doesn't end up mattering.
Yeah, but you still felt a little like, oh, I wish I could say goodbye.
I feel that, but I don't think that New Yorkers don't feel that. That's
right,
not their
life. Because they're always on the go.
They're on the go.
They're just like, yeah, what up? My next thing. It doesn't mean that the love is different. It's just the...
I don't like the Minnesota goodbye on phones. Do you this like
oh,
my
Lord.
Parents?
You were just telling
my
me
mom.
About
yeah.
your
dad.
You were just
I'm like,
about
okay,
your mom.
It's been good. All right. Like, no, I'm
you
sensing.
Say bye.
I
you
say bye. And then she's like,
you hang up.
Oh,
no,
did
you,
you
hang
talk
up.
To grandma recently? And she'll think of something else to talk about. My I don't
oh, you
care
tell
my mom
person.
Kinda does that too.
Yeah.
You're like, okay, mom.
Just drag
love
it out
you.
A little bit. Yeah. Well, she loves you.
Oh, wait, so one more thing. One more thing really quick.
One more thing.
Really quick.
Like, gots to go. Now I blame everything
is that
on my
how
kid.
Your mom's bad at that or
well,
you do?
Well, so I never noticed it, but yeah, my husband one time said, do you know how many times you and your mom just said goodbye to each other?
Right. Because I'm like,
no.
Something.
Yeah. We're like, Oh, wait, really quick. I just got to tell you this last little thing, you know.
That happens to, that happens at parties, too. You're like, hey, nice to see you. And they're like, hey, what about that one thing?
Oh, yeah.
And then it leads to another conversation.
Like, oh, yeah.
It just never ends.
Obligated, like, I have to say one more thing. Not on the phone with my mom or something, but, like, if you're leaving a party, it's like, you don't want to just say goodbye. You have to, like,
great hot dish.
Yeah, like compliment.
Send me the recipe.
One more little, you know.
So are you offended if you're hosting the party and somebody Minnesota
I would be mad if
goodbye?
Someone didn't say goodbye to me and I was hosting.
If you were like, hey, if the
and then I would
like,
pass aggressively
weird.
Say it to you like, where'd you go?
Mm.
Oh, I missed you. I guess I didn't see
I must
you
have
leave.
Not,
but deep down,
you
like,
are
how
passive.
Dare you?
You're not passive. Like, I am not passive at all. With my friends, I'd be like, I'd be like, Jesse, why did you leave early? I didn't like that. You know?
Oh, I would never
you get
do
your
that.
Lower tone voice. Yeah.
Jesse, come over here. I'm going
why
to
did you leave me? I am your father.
No, I don't know. Like, your closest people you should be able
no,
to
yeah,
sass.
No, yeah, I would yell at you if you just left my house and didn't say bye.
Right.
Yeah, I don't think I ever have. Yeah. I think it's always like,
usually I'm like, it's 1 a.m., get yeah. out.
Oh, and you're like, oh, by the way, here, I have this for you. Oh, you I get do, some yeah. food.
The
oh,
Minnesota thing, I go through my pantry.
I have this extra six-pack. Do you want it? You should take it home with you.
I give a lot of food.
That's ridiculous.
I go through my fridge. I'm like, here's the old condiments. I don't know. I don't want any of this.
It's such a weird phenomenon.
Why are you giving
me ketchup? Still getting used to it.
And you have to, so you first, you kind of, well, it's about time to go. Okay, cool. So we're in the living room. We say goodbye. Then you got to follow them to the door mm-hmm. and make mm-hmm. sure you say goodbye there. Sometimes you can even mm-hmm. walk outside while they're walking.
Do the wave.
Yeah, definitely do the wave. And then I always want to make sure I look and wave, and then they wave out the window.
And then you lock too. The doors. Yeah.
Okay, they've driven away. Okay, now we're
And then
good.
You pull out of the parking or the garage, and then you stop, and you wave again.
One more wave at the top of the driveway.
And then you drive to the stop sign, and then you look back and wave again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I was talking about this a little bit. My husband's just from Wisconsin, so not that far away, but he notices a difference.
Yeah.
Between Wisconsin and Minnesota?
Yeah.
In terms
there
of
is a I wouldn't think there would be. I just figured
there is
that
a
they
difference.
Would do the same.
So I've lived there for 7 years.
Into Wisconsin there's a difference. Further. He's in the Milwaukee
So it's
area,
a uniquely Minnesota passive. Thing.
I didn't think I it think was, so. But apparently he tells me it is. Okay. So.
They're close, but I think Minnesotans yeah. are more passive. Mm-hmm. Wisconsin mm-hmm. people are, like, I moved into my house here and only one person came and gave me something. In Wisconsin, like 25 people gave me something.
That's so
I hate
nice.
To trash Minnesota. Not trashing. They're scared. I think they're a little scared. Uh-huh. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
They're a little scared.
Scared of new people.
In Wisconsin, they're like, the guys used to have bonfires in the front yard in Wisconsin so they could, when I drove home from work, they'd be they like, get over here.
Yeah. That's
here's a
thing.
Beer.
Yeah.
It was a little bit more aggressive hangout in Wisconsin. And I think that's the alcohol. I do.
And then you never leave and you just sleep on the couch.
Because who wants to drink alone?
Nobody.
And Wisconsinites drink 10x than on Minnesotans. So
I thought it would be the same.
I always thought that until I lived there. I always thought, yeah, we're the same. Then I'm like, nah, they drink way more than we do.
Iowans, too.
And John knows.
Iowans do drink a lot as well.
I do know.
My couple years in Iowa, in Cedar Rapids, I mean.
Yeah, they drink a lot there.
Oof, yeah.
I don't know, because Minneapolis is health conscious, maybe. In Wisconsin, definitely not.
It's all cheese and beer.
You're well, right. I'm not. It's good and bad. It's good. It's just a little different. Yeah. Would you agree?
My husband, he gets mad at me when I say that. So
is he watching?
He's like, that's not true. And I'm like,
that we're different?
It might be.
That we're different?
It is. No, it's tough. I think it's true.
Yeah. There's similarities, but there's definitely.
I just know he's probably not watching right now. So I'm probably.
Gosh, safe. I got you in trouble.
No, it's okay.
Well, tizzy.
I like both.
Yes, I love both.
I'm more of a Minnesotan, so.
Yes.
You
yes.
Are, I guess you
same.
Are.
Same.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I mean, Lisa, you have experience with
both
states.
It's funny because I grew up, my friends who are from Wisconsin, my best friends, we went to high school and middle school there together. But I grew up, I was born and raised in Minnesota. Yeah. We moved.
Right.
And then I went back to Minnesota for college, and I kind of, that was like my home turf.
Yeah.
And that's where most of my family lives.
Yep.
So. I claim Minnesotan.
Okay, but what's
but
your take on this?
But I have ties in Ascani. I agree wholeheartedly. Yes, okay. It is different.
It is. Yeah.
We're so close to the border in Osceola, it's so hard to feel like a Wisconsinite.
True.
I don't know. We're so close to, like, I grew up watching KARE 11 living in Wisconsin.
Oh, right. Sure. Right.
Like, that was the major, like, we're only an hour away from, you know, Twin Cities Metro. Mm-hmm. So.
The difference for me is that they have birthday parties and bars. In Wisconsin. You'd never do that here.
With, like, kids?
Yeah.
Or bowling alleys?
Yeah, a lot of, like, I would go, one time I was in downtown Madison, we were drinking, like our plane was going down or something, and
That's one way to put it. Wow, I never heard that before.
Shout out to Rob, sorry. Stole that from my best friend. And anyways, there was a birthday party going on in the back.
For a child.
With, like, a 10-year-old.
I feel like that shouldn't be a thing, but...
It is.
You go Wisconsin.
So I don't know how else to explain. Like, that would never happen in Minnesota.
Yeah.
No. That would ignite all kinds of firestorms.
That was... For me, that is, like, that's the quintessential difference.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Kids are allowed in bars in Wisconsin, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think you can still
drink
with your
parents. I think they're allowed here, too. They just can't sit at the bar.
Okay.
But yeah. I think... Isn't it once you're 18... Or is it 18 in Wisconsin?
I think it's 15.
You're with your parents?
You can have a drink.
Yep. 15.
No.
I'm pretty sure it's 15.
Wow.
We gotta look this up.
It is also up to the bar.
Okay.
The bartender's gonna be like, no, we don't feel cool about
also,
that.
Also, D-dubs, you can get like 14 D-dubs there.
I don't, so, are we saying accurate statements right now? We're just like,
we need to look this up.
I put the word, like in front of it, which allowed lying.
Yeah, that's okay.
Give us your like forecast.
Yeah, it's going to be like 30 degrees
like
today,
50,
right?
Next
yeah.
week.
Oh, no.
Oh, we're getting the forecast.
Like 40 yeah. degrees.
36 every day. Jeez. It's going to be crummy and gross and warm.
Tomorrow?
I don't like tomorrow morning. I'm a little worried about tomorrow morning.
How warm are we getting next week? Is it like trending 50s? Like, are we gonna melt the?
I just don't know. Things I don't know. When people are like, is it gonna be? I know it's gonna be warm, like 45. But I don't know if there's gonna be fog. If there's fog, the day's jacked. You're not gonna get to 50 if it's foggy. Mm-hmm. Don't care. Mm-hmm. So I can't tell you sunshine and cloud cover that far out. I know we're in a warm period, so I know it's at least probably 35. But is it 35 or is it 55? There are
it's
nuances.
Gonna be warm,
there are nuances that matter there.
Yeah. Okay, so stay tuned to the forecast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's a wrap from us.
Yeah.
Joe, hey. If you're watching, congrats.
Congrats, man.
Roll back the burns.
Thank you for watching as well. Sign that contract. Stay with us.